Here's Johnny.
It's caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
Hey everybody, this is 22 Tiger Dude here, and I am here to review The Shining, starring Jack Nicholson and directed by Stanley Kubrick. Before I review this film though, my guest star Brian Mendoza is going to review this film. So, Brian Mendoza, take it away, dude.
Hey guys, it's Brian Mendoza here, and I gotta say, Tony, thanks for inviting me to the Halloween reviews this year again. I appreciate it. And if you guys are not subscribed to Tony, aka 22 Tire Dude, please subscribe to him. He's one of my very good friends. I appreciate the support, by the way, for watching, buddy. But you know what? Let's move on. I'll talk about The Shining. Yes. The Shining from, what year is this film? 1980. How is this from 1980? This is crazy, you know? I just watched this recently this year in March, believe it or not. And yes, I did watch it with surround sound. And The Shining is basically about Jack Nicholson. He takes his family to this hotel. And all I'm going to say, things get crazy. That's all I'm going to say. The Shining is one of the most creepiest horror movies I've ever seen in my life, you know? The acting is great, you know? Jack Nicholson, he's insane in this movie, I gotta say that. Shelley Duvall, she was good as the wife. I forgot the name because it's been a while since I've seen it, but I know what it's about. There's so many scenes that I don't want to spoil for this video. But just, I mean, there's so many iconic stuff in this movie, especially the hotel, the hallway scenes. They're just creepy. Those two twins. Come play with us. This movie's really creepy. But you know what? I love it. It's one of my favorite horror movies of all time. It's also one of my favorite films of all time. But you know what? I'm giving this thing an A+. This is a fantastic film. And yeah, that's my thoughts on The Shining. I hope you guys enjoyed my thoughts on it.
Thank you so much, Brian Mendoza, for reviewing The Shining. What can I say about The Shining? It's a really, really fantastic movie. This is a well-directed movie from Stanley Kubrick. He does a fantastic job with this film. He gets you really immersed into this world with this psychopathic father. And I mean, wow. Yeah, Jack Nicholson is really intimidating as the lead character. As the film progresses, you get more scared of Johnny, his character, and when his character pops up, you can just really feel the intensity, and it makes you glad that you are not near this character because he is a psychopath, and he is so psychopathic that he's willing to come after his wife and his own kid. This dude really is a fucking psycho. Wow. But no, in all seriousness, this is a very suspenseful movie. The imagery is very haunting. It's definitely a creepy movie. The cinematography looks beautiful. And it has some very incredible shots. Like, there is this shot where Jack Nicholson's little son is just riding in his bike around the hotel. The camera just kind of moves as he's riding on the bike all slowly. And the way that happens is so good. It's kind of like you're there with that little boy on the bike around this hotel. So I think Stanley Kubrick does a really good job of trying to keep you really immersed as the audience. And to me, he really does do a very successful job at doing that. He does a very successful job of making Jack Nicholson's character very frightening, disturbing, intimidating. The actress that plays the wife who has to avoid him as the film is progressing, she actually did a good job too. And the kid actually did a nice job as the son as well. So there were no bad performances in this film. Everyone does a great job for the fantastic material that they are given. The music is really haunting and it's very beautifully composed. The music matches the overall tone of The Shining very well. Every time you hear it along with the creepy sound effects and the stuff that goes on, it really gives you the goosebumps. And The Shining, I also gotta say, has a twist I didn't see coming, and once that twist came, my mind was seriously fucking blown. It's one of the best twists I've ever seen in this film. I do have a couple of minor flaws with The Shining. One flaw involves this scene with a naked woman. Yeah, and that's a scene that didn't really creep me out. It actually made me laugh, but I don't know. It's all like, of all moments, that scene wasn't really necessary. I actually found that to be an awkward and weird, out of place scene. I didn't think that naked woman scene in the movie was necessary. And I did think the finale, without spoiling anything, but like the final, I would say the final like 10 minutes of the movie, I believe. It started from there where I felt like the movie kind of lost its steam and you're all like, okay, yeah, you're kind of losing the steam now. Kind of wrap it up. I am going to give The Shining 4 out of 4 stars. It's a near perfect movie. The Shining is awesome. It's beautifully directed. It's well acted. It's well shot. It's well written. It's very crazy. And it has some of the creepiest music as well as some of the creepiest imageries to give me goosebumps. I just want to give a special thank you to Brian Mendoza for reviewing The Shining with me. Thank you very much, dude. Please check out Brian Mendoza's channel. I will leave a link in the description below.